The Stourport drill hall on Lion Hill was actually the third drill hall in Stourport, the first being in part of the tannery, the second being down by the basins in Mart Lane. The land, which had originally been called the Rickyard, was acquired. Previously it had been used for visiting fairs and circuses. The drill hall was completed in 1911 and opened by the Earl of Dudley with Stanley Baldwin and his wife present. During the First World War, the hall became the centre of recruitment for local men joining the regiment, which was C Company, Worcestershire Regiment. In the 1920s, with life returning to normal, the hall became a centre of many different sorts of entertainment. Chiefly among them were Saturday night dances. In the days of the uneasy peace of the 1930s, many young men joined the Terriers. And on that fateful Sunday morning, the 3rd of September 1939, local men were called to the colours. Once again, the hall became a hive of military activity. Following Dunkirk, the Home Guard was formed when the hall became their headquarters. With the arrival of the American forces at nearby Burlish Camp, the drill hall became a centre for their activities and dances, where they obviously played music in the Millard manner. Following peace being declared, the hall again reverted to entertainment, with local bands playing for dances. People like Jack Turner, Johnny Hay, and Fred Reynolds. With the ending of national service in the 1960s, the hall was only used by the Territorials and the Army Cadet Force, and it quickly deteriorated. Thank you. At the rear of this rifle range, there used to stand Stourports Mortuary. In 2002, the land and buildings were sold to a developer on the understanding that the Sergeant Instructor's House would become part of any new development. So although the old building is gone, we have these reminders of the joys and sorrows associated with this building, Stourports Drill Hall.